How's it going, everyone? This is Mr. Morales. In this video, we're going to look at finding the average, minimum, and maximum values in a range. We're also going to look at the difference between relative and absolute cell references. Let's begin. We have this spreadsheet, sales for computer parts. We have different computer parts on the left. We have the months at the top as our columns. And we have the totals already filled out on both sides. Now our goal is to find the average of this range, which is B4 to B8. We want to find the average value in this range of cells. We also want to find the minimum value of this range of cells, and we want to find the maximum value of this range of cells. So the minimum and maximum are easy. You can spot them. Minimum is going to be 10. That's the lowest number. Maximum will be 200. Average will be a little tougher for us to calculate in our heads. So we want Excel to do this for us. We want to start off by clicking on the cell where we want our answer at. So I want my answer for the average to be on cell B11. And all I have to do now is simply go to the top where the ribbon, go to the functions button, click on the little arrow, and here we will find the most common functions. If we can't find the function we're looking for, we're going to click on more functions, and that's where we can type in a description of our function that we're looking for and search for it. In this case, our function is here, it's average, so we click on average. And Excel is thinking that we want to find the range or the average of the range B4 to B10. Notice how it's even including a blank cell. So we don't want that. What we're going to do is simply click and drag the range that we want. So we're clicking B4 to B8. We notice that it's here. Once it's correct, then we press the enter button. And now we have the average of B4 to B8. We do the same thing with minimum. In this case, it's called min. And once again, it's thinking of a different range. We click and drag the proper range that we want, press enter. We move on to the next one, maximum. We go to max. We select the proper range. Notice how we're excluding the totals. We don't want the total in our calculation. The boss wants us to find the maximum value in sales for our particular product. We press enter. And now we have those values. Remember, once we have one of the values, as we do in each of these cases, then we use the fill handle, which is the black cross, which can be located at the bottom right of the cell, and we can click and drag and we fill in all of those values. Notice how some decimal points came up. If we want to keep those, we can, or we can decrease by going to the ribbon under the number group and the decrease decimal command. We could click on that and the decimal was removed. You can do the same thing here, or we can increase it. Now, suppose your boss wants to increase sales. Currently, these are the sales for each product, and he wants to increase the sales, and he wants to set a goal. Let's suppose the goal is 5%. We'll go to cell G2 and we can click, or we can type 5%. We can modify if it actually we'll type 0.05, then 0.05 is 5%. Then we can go to under the general drop down under the number group. We can choose percentage. Likewise, we can just use 0.05. Whichever method you want is fine. We'll stick to 5%, 5.00%. That's fine. And what we're going to do is multiply. We'll start off with RAM, our first item. The total for RAM was 238, and we're going to multiply that times 5%. We're going to type equal sign. We're going to click on cell F4. We'll multiply by typing in an asterisk, and now we will click on cell G2. I press enter on the keyboard, and that gives me 11.9. So 11.9 is 5% of 238. But that doesn't mean that that does not include the 238. So our boss says, I want to set a goal of increasing our total by 5%. That must include the current total. So how can I do that? So I can, there's two several ways. I can simply add, under the formula bar, I can add F4 again, or another way is to modify my percentage and type, make it 105%. So when I do this, I'm automatically including the 238, which is in cell F4, in addition to the 11.9. So notice when I press enter, my answer will be roughly about 249. I believe it'll be 249.9. Let's see if it's true. Yes, 249.9 is my answer. So 249.9 is an increase of 5% of 238, including the 238. Okay. Likewise, if we wanted to use, if we didn't want to use percentage, we would use 1.05 as the number. Let me delete this. The final thing I want to show you is now that we have one, now we can just simply use the fill handle and drag down. But wait a minute, what happened here? We have a bunch of zeros that came up. This is a mistake. Something wrong happened. The reason this occurred is because Excel is not smart enough to figure out that G2 is a fixed cell. In other words, it's an absolute cell reference. An absolute cell reference is a reference that does not change when you copy the formula. So when we do the sum function, Excel's smart enough to figure out, oh, okay, he wants to copy this range of on the B column. Now on the C column, he wants to copy the C, everything within the range of that, and so on and so forth. But when I do the fill handle here, I'm double clicking, I'll double click on this one, and notice how it's shifting one cell down every time. It's trying to figure out our pattern, and it didn't figure it out correctly. So it's multiplying, Excel is multiplying cell F5 times G3, the next cell, which is H6, it's multiplying F6 times F4, and as you can see, it's just shifting. It's figuring out the pattern, but it didn't figure it out correctly. So how do we fix that? So just to backtrack one more time, the sum function uses what's called a relative cell reference, and that's a reference that looks at the relationship of the cells and formula. Pretty much it's same formula, different cell reference. For an absolute cell reference, we're using the same cell. So the way to do that is to go to H4, and the cell reference that does not change will be cell G2. So on the formula bar, what we do is before the G, we type in a dollar sign, and before the 2, we type in another dollar sign, and this tells Excel that this reference is going to stay fixed. I press enter. Now when I do the fill handle, I get my proper results. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you on the next video.